Hello and welcome to the session in which you would look at dollar value LIFO. It's very important to distinguish dollar value LIFO from traditional LIFO. Traditional LIFO is what we learned in prior session where we keep track of inventory per unit separately. And for a lot of companies, they have many, many units, thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of small units. So it's very expensive to keep track of inventory per unit. It's time consuming and it could be subject to LIFO liquidation because you are eroding old layers. So the old layers are there and you're identifying them specifically. The dollar value LIFO is a little bit different. It's simpler, although you might think it's a little bit more challenging for us. Hopefully I can simplify it, but it creates pools, dollar quantity of inventory rather than keeping per unit. So under the traditional LIFO, we keep track of everything in unit, which is time consuming. Under dollar value LIFO, we're going to group stuff together, inventory together, and keep track of it in dollar amount. Specifically, item that faces the same price changes. In other words, they go up and down in prices in the same way, or they go up and down and they cancel each other. That somehow it makes sense to put them together. For example, flat screen TV, smart TVs, DVDs, they all electronics, so they work the same way from year to year. So the purpose of dollar value LIFO is to reduce LIFO liquidation. Reduce it, not eliminate it. Eliminated. You could still be subject to a little bit of erosion, but you would reduce it and you would reduce clerical cost to keep track, clerical cost errors to keep track of each unit separately. The best way to illustrate this concept is to actually look at an example. Before we look at an example, I just want to let you know that whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhadlectures.com, I don't replace your CPA review course or your accounting course. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition to your accounting course. I explain the material differently. I offer you additional resources, additional explanation, the theory behind the concept. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Give me a try. If you like it, you keep it. If it's feel it's helping you, you will know the difference. If not, that's fine. Then it doesn't work for you. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university is doing on the CPA exam. I do have resources for other college courses. You can take a look at them here. Advanced accounting, managerial accounting, auditing, so on and so forth. My CPA materials are aligned with your Becker, Roger, Gleam, Wiley, Sergeant, so on and so forth. And I do give you access to all the AI CPA previously released questions, 1,500 of them with detailed solution. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. The way we convert inventory to dollar value LIFO is through a three-step process. It's very important to understand those three-step process. And what I mean, understand, means absorb what you are doing. You can memorize the steps, but if you absorb, if you understand it, it makes it much easier to recall. Step one, we're going to deflate ending inventory to current prices using a conversion index. Okay, so we're going to be giving, you might be giving FIFO, and you'll be told to convert to dollar value LIFO. So the first thing you do is you deflate ending inventory to current prices using conversion rate. Then you're going to compute the difference, and the difference will be the layer of ending inventory either created or sometime eroded. Your inventory might go down, and you're going to take this layer and you're going to reinflate this layer using the cost index in the year acquired. Very important, the cost index of the year acquired. I'm going to look at an introductory example here. So listen to me carefully. I'm going to look at an introductory example here. In the next session, you're going to have a more advanced example. So first learn the basics, then learn how to do the advanced example. Let's take a look at this example. Adam Company was using dollar value LIFO method on January 1st, X1, when the inventory cost was $400,000. December 31st, X1, which is the end of the year, the inventory was $455,800, and the cost index for the year was 1.06 or 106%. Okay, let's go through this process. Now we need to know what is our dollar value LIFO. First step, let's look. Deflate ending inventory using conversion index, the conversion, which is the inflation rate. Well, let's do that. How do you do this? You deflate. We're going to take 455,800 current prices, divide it to take out the inventory, and now we're going to come up to 430,000. What does that mean? It means The true increase, if we factor the inventory out, is from 400 to 430. So there was an increase of 30,000 of new inventory. So we factor out the inventory from the total figure. That's step one. So we're done with step one. Step two, find the difference in the layers. Let's see if we added a layer or if we eroded a layer. Obviously, I just told you we added a layer of 30,000. Therefore, what we did in step two basically saying you started with 400,000, you added a layer. Now your inventory at base year compared to base year, you had 430,000. So if we're comparing base prices to base prices between year one, the beginning of year one till the end of year one. Okay, this is 2001, which is December 31st. So comparing the beginning 1-1-2001 or 20X1 to 12/31/20X1, we're talking about a $30,000 layer. So this is step two, done with step two. So we added a layer. Sometimes the layer might be eroded, and this is what I will do in the next session when you would look at the example. Then what we look at, now we're going to reinflate each layer using the cost index in the year acquired. It's very important. So let's take a look at the first layer. The first layer is the 400,000, which is 1-1-20X1. What's the price index? Always year one, because it's your base year. It will be 100% or just one. So ending inventory will be 400,000 for 1-1-20X1. The second layer, I'm going to reinflate. Remember, I added 30,000 of base dollar, but I had a 6% inflation. Now I'm going to reinflate this 30,000. It's going to be reinflated, and I'm going to multiply it by 1.06, and that's going to give me 31,800. Now I know my dollar value LIFO is 431,800. So this is my dollar value LIFO. Now what I need to do, I need to make a journal entry to reconcile between my dollar value LIFO and my FIFO. Okay, if I was using FIFO. What do I need to do? Well, my FIFO, the method that I was using, was 455,800. Therefore, I need to reduce my inventory to this much. I'm going to create an allowance account, and I'm going to reduce my inventory. Therefore, my cost of goods sold will go up by the difference of 24,000. There's a difference of 24,000. And I will credit allowance to reduce inventory, which is a contra asset. It means this is going to stay with you from year to year. In the next session, when I go from year to year, I'm going to keep track of this account. So this is, again, a balance sheet account. It means it's a permanent account. It means you have to account for it from year to year. So this is the entry that you make to come up to dollar value LIFO. You reduced your inventory and you increased your cost of goods sold. Now let's talk about the conversion index or the consumer price index. Well, the conversion index, the consumer price index, the inflation index, whatever you want to use. Most companies uses the one that's provided by the government, which is called the consumer price index, which is CPI, and you know, company can use this. Companies can use more specific price index. For example, if your industry is very specialized, for example, oil prices changes differently than electronics. Electronics, they may deflate from year to year. They may not have inflation. They, you know, electronics equipment, they get cheaper because to produce them, companies are more and more efficient because of advancement in technology versus oil. Or the company can compute their own internal price index. And if you want to compute your own internal price index, what you will do is you will take your ending inventory at current prices and you will divide your ending inventory at current prices by the same inventory that compared to the prior year base at cost. Simply put, let's assume last year something cost you $9,000. Okay? Now this year, the same items, the same exact item are costing you, let's assume, 10,600. So what you do is you will take 10,600 divided by 9,000. That's 1.177. Let's round it, 1.18. So it's approximately, you're talking about an increase in prices of 18%. So what you did is you computed your own price index, your own consumer price index. It's your own internal one. So you want to make sure you understand how to compute this, because on the CPA exam or in your courses, you might be expected to compute the consumer price index. Take your ending inventory at current cost divided by the prior year based cost. And if it's most likely it's an increase, especially these days. If you think about what's going on in the economy now, we're experiencing inflation. Companies will have to make sure they're using the proper consumer price index. Actually, the consumer price index this last week rose the most since year 1990. Okay, This is, I believe, went up to 6.2%, which is quite high relative to the recent history. Anyhow, make sure in the next recording you would look at the example where I work a comprehensive, where we have an erosion, okay, in the layers for dollar value LIFO. At the end of this recording, I'm going to ask you again to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I don't replace your accounting course. I'm a useful addition. I can help you. I can supplement your material by providing you alternative resources, alternative explanation. That's going to help you. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Your CPA, your accounting degree is a lifetime investment. Study hard. Good luck. Get done with it. Study hard, of course, and stay safe.